should've fought it. At least I'm being honest.
Mucho más, porque queremos venir a más fiestas. Que un feliz cumpleaños.
La mejor sorpresa es que Byron, cuando ella tenía 2 años, decía: a ver cuándo mi hija tiene cumple 15 años otra vez. Le digo: no, si no ha cumplido ninguno, hasta ahorita va a cumplirlo. Y ahorita anda bien contento, le estaba diciendo. Yo le dice: felicidades por sus 15, mía. Es el papá feliz.
¿Usted va a llorar?
Nomás queremos felicitar a Mía por sus 15 años, a mi hermano, a Leida, fueron unos momentos muy difíciles para la fiesta, pero todo está saliendo muy hermoso y la vamos a disfrutar mucho. ¡Mucho tequila!
Pues yo quiero desearle muchísimos años más. ¡Ay! Pero no quiero llorar. A mi nieta, y que Dios me la bendiga y que siga en sus estudios, comportarse como una niña como ha sido y que siga siendo todo el tiempo. Y la quiero mucho.
Welcome everyone. Estamos aquí reunidos para hacer una quinceañera y celebrar la vida de Mia Lozano, que está entrando en una época muy bonita de su vida. She's entering right now. Mia is entering into a new stage in her life. And I want you to take a deep breath and relax. It's gonna be okay. I promise you. Va a estar todo bien. And folks, if you'd like to, you can come a little bit closer. I promise I won't bite you. Si quieren ir con eso aquí más enfrente, están invitados, por favor, no tengan pena. Muy bien, ok, vamos a empezar con una oración. We're going to begin with a word of prayer. I'm going to ask you to please pray with me. Voy a pedirles que, por favor, oren conmigo. Let us pray. Father God, we are gathered on this beautiful afternoon, Lord, to just thank you for the life of Mia. We thank you for 15 years. 15 beautiful years with her, and as we get to celebrate now this new time in her life, we just want to honor you and honor her as well for all the good things in her life. Señor, te damos gracias por Mia. Señor, te damos gracias por la vida de ella, por que buena hija y amiga es ella, y que la sigas bendiciendo, Señor, que siga creciendo y amándote a ti y su familia. Señor, pedimos una bendición sobre ella. Amén. So Mia, I know it's kind of hard with the sun, but I'm going to try to speak to you, right? Because this is your day. Te voy a hablar a ti. And as I was talking earlier with your mother, she was telling me all about like how you're an honor roll student, academic, all-star, a tennis player. You want to grow up to be a psychiatrist. You love your family. Eres una muchacha muy bien, que buena estudiante con muchos, tienes metas grandes. You have big goals. And that's beautiful, and that's a good thing to have. And you need to go after that with all your heart. Tienes que seguir esas metas y tratar de hacer lo mejor que puedas para darle honra a tu familia y a Dios y a ti misma también. Pero este es un día muy especial. This is a very special day. Tiene un significado muy bonito. Es el día que tú entras, sales de la niñez y entras ser una mujer. This is the day where you take a public step from being a child into young womanhood. And so as you take these steps, this important step, I'm going to encourage you with just a few words from the Bible. Te voy a dar unas palabras de ánimo de la Biblia. So right now, in the book of 1 Corinthians 13:11, there's a scripture that I think really applies to today. Hay una escritura que es muy bonita. It says, when I was a child, I talked like a child, and I thought like a child, and I reasoned like a child. So when I became a woman or an adult, I put the ways of childhood behind me. And what this is saying here, lo que está diciendo, es que right now, this is an opportunity for you to step up, to take a new step in your life, to take a new direction. And so your family, your friends, everyone who's here, we're here to cheer you on. In fact, I want everybody to cheer up Mia right now. Everybody give her a hand clap. And everybody's here because they love you and they're excited for you because they see all the potential that lies here. And so we're going to encourage you to step up into this new time in your life and to do that knowing that you have a community of family and friends. Look around here for a second. I know you're a little nervous, but go ahead and take a look. See all these people here? They're smiling at you. taking your picture, videotaping you, you know, putting your picture on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, you know, you're going to be trending worldwide. See, all these people are here to support you and to love you and to cheer you on. But I'm going to encourage you to remember one thing, really, really important thing, is to first and foremost, keep God first in your life. If you put God first, all these other things, he says in his word, will be added unto you. All these things that you're thinking about, that you will be thinking about college and about, you know, decisions in life, all these things will develop. You'll be shown what to do as long as you put God first and you continue to honor your parents and your family and keep doing the honor roll thing. That's awesome. Keep going, you know, all you can. Do all that right now. So trust in God. Keep him first. And also, go ahead and ask God for wisdom. The Bible says that in James chapter 5, if any of you lacks wisdom, you should ask God, who gives generously to all. And so you ask God for wisdom. Of course, these people right here next to me, your parents, they love you. They have your best intentions in mind. Listen to them. Listen to their advice. I know you have family and friends here that you listen to as well. Go to them, because some of us have been around a little bit longer and we've kind of gone through life. And so we're here to help you and to encourage you. And so go ahead and ask for that help when you need it. And I want to remind you this. Through it all, continue to honor your parents. Look at what they're doing for you here today. They're doing it because I know they love you and they cherish you. And they're here to encourage you and to cheer you on. And it's good. I'm glad I see the emotion coming through, and it's because you love them as well. And it's a beautiful thing to have this kind of love, because this is the foundation for your whole life. And so as you take this step into womanhood, remember, you have the love of God and you have the love of family and of all your friends who are here as well to cheer you on and to be there for you. And know this, that, oh, look at this. Look at the love right here. Just the tissues coming up to help you out here. I'm going to encourage you. There you go. Thank you. Muchas gracias. I'm going to encourage you to continue to put God first, honor your parents, your family, and go after those goals, and you will have a beautiful... You're doubly blessed here. That's good. You are going to have an amazing life. And so everyone who's here, I'm going to encourage all of you to do something with me. We're going to do a blessing together. Can we do that, family and friends? Podemos hacerle una bendición todos juntos. Padre, les voy a pedir que se vayan al lado de Mía y le pongan sus manos. If you would put your hand on her shoulders or on her head, whatever you feel more comfortable. And we're going to bless her. And the rest of us here, if you feel comfortable, if you can extend a hand of blessing and a prayer. Let's pray for her. Let's bless her. Let's encourage her. Let's do this together as a community that loves her. So Mía, let's pray. Father, I thank you, God, for Mia. I thank you for who she is. She's just an amazing young lady. And I just, the little while that I've known her, I can just see she's just a person who loves and cares. Is just a beautiful person inside and out. And so we ask for your blessing upon her. As she takes this amazing step into young womanhood, that you would guide and direct her, that you would show her how to live her life for you and for her family. And as a family, a community of people, we just want to love her and bless her and encourage her. Señor, te damos gracias por mí, Señor, que la bendigas, la guardes, que le des sabiduría en sus decisiones, que siempre honre a sus padres, sus familiares, y que siempre haga lo mejor para ti, Señor, y que tú la bendigas en este día muy hermoso, en esta nueva época de su vida, que la bendigas y la guíes, Señor. Muchas gracias. Amén. Amen. Parents, I want you to just go next to your daughter. Give her a big hug right now. This is beautiful. And family and friends, why don't we give her a round of applause? It's a beautiful moment, a beautiful time. Okay, so I want to just finish with this. Don't worry, I'm done after this, okay? You are at a beautiful time in your life. Remember to give it all you can with everything you have. All around us, all of us who've been around the block a little bit longer, we know that you are at a point in your life where you can do so many things. You have so many choices ahead of you. But remember this, love God, love your family, and do your best and you will succeed. You will be an amazing, you're already an amazing young lady, but the potential is here. I can see it. So just walk with God, walk with your family, and you will do so well. God bless you. And let me just do a final prayer before we have a time of celebration. Una oración última antes de la celebración. Father, thank you for me, Lord. I thank you for who she is. She is just an amazing young lady. Bless her, walk with her, and just allow her, Lord, to just draw closer to you. And I thank you for her family that just loves her and cherishes her as well. We just pray that all together we would just celebrate the goodness and the grace in her life. In Christ's name. And that concludes our ceremony. So happy birthday. Let's do one more round of applause.
Un aplauso para los papás de la Cintillera, por favor. Guadalupe y Aleja Lozada. Vamos a darle un aplauso a nuestra linda quinceañera mía, acompañada por sus hermanos, sus brothers, Byron y Brian Lozano. Un aplauso para ellos.
Yeah.
Ahora vamos a invitar al señor y la señora Lozano aquí enfrente donde está el grupo, porque vamos a tener unas lindas palabras que van a decir ellos, y también queremos que todos estén listos porque vamos a hacer un brindis.
Buenas noches a todos. Primero quiero darle gracias a Dios por habernos permitido saludarle a mi hija Luciana. Y gracias a todos por haberme venido a acompañar y agradecerle este día tan especial para nosotros. ¿Qué puedo decir yo? Es mi hija y la queremos mucho, estamos muy orgullosos de ella. Bueno, todos los que la conocen desde niña saben de que su papá ha planeado esto desde el día que ella nació. No quiso hablar por primera vez porque creo que le ganaría la emoción, por eso me dejó a mí el papel de hablar. Tenemos un año planeado, pero todo lo que ven aquí lo hizo Misaelito.
Muchas gracias.
Porque gracias a él es que está todo esto como está. Quiero darle gracias a Dios por haberme dado a una muy buena niña. Inteligente, muy, muy buena niña desde que era muy pequeñita, tiene un gran corazón, es bien noble y me da estoy muy, muy, muy orgullosa de ella y siempre le digo que me dio los peores 9 meses de mi vida, que fue horrible el vaso, pero me ha dado 15 años de muchos gustos, mucho orgullo, mucho de todo. Que yo le doy gracias, muchísimas gracias a Dios por haberme dado una niña tan buena. Y no quiere hablar, le dije que si hablara, y se puso a llorar, le dije que no. Pero le quiero dar gracias a todos por haber venido a celebrar esta ocasión tan especial para nosotros. Y muchísimas gracias a todos. Gracias.